Hello guys, welcome once more to Sinet TV. Today we'll be talking about Ukraine and students. If you are planning to come to Ukraine to come and study, this is what you have to know. And this is our talking point today on this particular video. Admission is currently going on in Ukraine now in universities, and many people are hoping to come to Ukraine and come and study, like foreign students who are coming in now. I know the situation in Africa. Most of the time, students want to leave Africa, come to Europe, and then come and study in the first of studying their work, and then in order to survive. But I want to tell you that coming to Ukraine to come and study is very, very good in terms of affording your meals, a house, to rent, whatsoever. It is affordable as compared to other parts of Europe. But now, how to make the money in the country to use it to pay some of these facilities is when the crisis and the chaos of Ukraine comes. I know many agents are out there doing a good job by bringing many students to Ukraine to come and study. If you are that kind of person that you are leaving Africa to come to Ukraine, or Asia to come to Ukraine to come and study, and you have your parents who are ready to sponsor you through your studies, that you will not be able to, like, you'll not be able to be depending on any other thing like work. Everything is going to work for you. It's going to work for you and work for you well. Yeah, since your income is coming from outside, you are using it to sponsor yourself without working, only focusing on your studies. It's going to work well. But if you are coming here like somebody who has borrowed money from uncle, brother, sister, or family, or even sell one of your properties to come here and study, it's going to be tough for you. It's going to be very difficult because there will be no other source of income that you use to survive here. And even though there are other things that you do behind the scene to use to survive, since foreign students working in Ukraine is illegal, there are other things that people do behind the scene to survive. But concerning those things, I will not be talking about it in this video because they are rough. And now the next video that will be coming up, maybe I will say it in it, but if you want to know about it, put it in the comment section so that I bring it to you in the next video. There are very rough things. I call it very rough things because they are very rough things. And then again, concerning another challenge that you'll be facing here, if you're coming to Ukraine to come and study like a student, this is what you have to put in mind. First of all, Ukraine is having two languages, but their main official language is Ukrainian, which is their Ukrainian, which is their official, which is their language. And then they also have another language, which is Russia. You know, Ukraine just separated almost about 30 years ago from Russia, which was during the period of Soviet Union. And now, most of them, in fact, about 80% of the country speak Russian. And one of the things that you face as a challenge of language is when you go to the classroom, first year, they use first year to teach you how to study Ukrainian language in class. The moment you study it in class and then coming out of class to practice it in the society with people, you know, it's going to be very, very tough, because when you come outside, you are speaking to people in Ukrainian, they are looking at you as funny somebody, because everybody in the society is speaking like Russia, but these people are not ready to teach you the Russia in the classroom. So these are some of the challenges that you also go through, that you'll be forced to learn the two languages at once to be able to survive. And this is what I wanted you to know in this video. The main message is, before you come to Ukraine, if you have, as a student, before you come to Ukraine as a student to come and study, if you have your sponsors that will carry you throughout your education, you are a safe person. I'm talking like somebody who is studying in Ukraine. Yeah, I have my own conditions that I used to come here, but I'm studying in Ukraine. So if you want to use this place like a transit, I'm going to get to that in another video. And I'm going to talk about that. I'm not going to talk about that in this video because I only aim this video to be for one interest, and that interest is only to let you know the conditions you should use to come here. And the interest is, before you come to Ukraine to come and study, have your sponsors. If you have your sponsors that will carry you throughout your education, you are safe. But if you think that you come and make money in Ukraine to use it to pay your education and further your studies, it's not going to work. Put this in your mind, it's not going to work unless you get yourself involved into bad things. I mean, bad things. So if you want to ask or know anything about Ukraine, just put it in the comment section. I will be doing the video for you. I've been living in Ukraine for some time, and I know what is going on, and I know how the country is operating in terms of academies, you know, and other things. So Thank you very much. Stay safe. My name is Charles. Please don't forget to hit the subscription bell so that when we upload these videos, you'll be able to watch another video will be coming up on Monday. Stay tuned and stay blessed. Thank you very much. Bye.